all these GPUs are starting to look alike. Today we have another 40 series tough card, and it is not the 4060 Ti, even though it looks just like it, same thickness and everything. You'll notice the main key takeaway on the outside isn't a single 8-pin, it's a dual 8-pin via one of these 12-volt 2x6 connectors. This is an RTX 4070 Ti Super, the dumbest consumer graphics card name ever to grace anywhere, really. But I got one of these insanely on launch day for $110 under MSRP on a local group from somebody that had to burn some gift cards, so I bought it, and I ran it. On the right side of your screen, you will see in typical OvalClocking form, the spreadsheet. Starting up here, we have the test date, the drivers used. I will say, to mine with this, if you're using Hive OS, hey, link in the description if you're not, please use it. It gives me money, and I need a lot of money for my Hive OS because it costs a fortune to run it. But you need to go in to your Hive shell or on the keyboard on the physical machine and do hive-replace space dash dash list enter option 2 enter yes enter, and then once it's completely come back up, you need to do nvidia-driver-update space dash list enter, and then you need to type in the current driver version, which is very important because the drivers just launched today with this card, and without the current drivers this may not work at all. So I had today's drivers loaded on this thing, and it'll ask you for a driver version. You just type in 550.40.07, enter, and it will go. If you're watching this after, we'll say April of 2024, that is probably not relevant anymore, so skip ahead. Anyway, right into Hashrates. I started off with Flux. So I ran it stock, just because when I first kicked the flight sheet to it, that's what happens. This card is capable of 116 souls at 300 watts, which is insane. I mean, that's like 40, well, I don't actually know, but it's like 3090 hash rate, so that's kind of impressive, but the power is just bananas. What we ended up seeing for the ultimate efficiency was 74.6 souls, which is still quite good, an efficiency of 0.58. So 0.50 and better, I consider pretty good. Moving on to Nexa. This is actually the most efficient Nexa result I've ever tested on any card. 0.647, higher is better. 0.55 is really good. Not only that, but the hash rate is insanely high. Dynex, a little bit lower hash rate than I would like to see, but this is still 1.0 miner, and there isn't official support for this card on OZM yet, nor is there on the new BZ miner beta or real release, so we'll come back to Dynex. I don't think that hash rate and efficiency is quite right. Even still, it's exactly the same numbers and efficiency as the CMP50HX, which is no slouch. Those are great cards for Dynex mining. Alephium, really good hash rate, reasonably good efficiency. It's not like standout great, but anything over 15 is pretty good in my mind. And we're at 15.69, nice. Ironfish, hash rate's really strong, but the efficiency is only meh. You can see it's actually red there. Not great in my mind. Carlson, really, really good hash rate density and excellent efficiency. Ergo, phenomenal hash rate, really good efficiency. ETC hash, like Ethereum Classic, Hypera, soon to be Fish hash, things like that. Really strong hash rate, and I would say good efficiency. So we're looking at 3060, 3070, 3060 Ti efficiency there. So good, but not insane. Pigeon Coin, good hash rate, very, very mediocre to somewhat poor efficiency. Kapow, good hash rate, but downright poor efficiency. Nvidia just still isn't good at Kapow for whatever reason. They just don't have Team Redminer writing the optimizations for their cards. Cortex, good hash rate, very good efficiency. This is actually, I think 19 or 20 is what I consider to be good, and this is at 30. And again, higher is better, so that's 50% higher efficiency than a quite efficient card. So Cortex, if you like that project, might be worth looking at this bad boy. Conflux, again, quite good. Good efficiency, really good hash rate. This card does have some very strong Micron, I think 19 or 21 gigabit per second GDDR6X. And the thing that really differentiates this from the regular 4070 Ti is the memory bus. This essentially has a 3070 Ti memory bus, and the other card has basically a beefed up RTX 3060 memory bus. So we made significant strides in memory hard algorithms with this card. And the core is bumped up a little bit too. Some more CUDA cores, some more TMUs, some more tensor cores, things like that. So anyway, that is the gist of this card. It's pretty good. The only caveat I have is it's way too expensive. If you compare this thing to even other 40 series cards, it cost more than twice what this 4060 Ti 8GB OC did from Micro Center, new. That was $350. This was, well, $870, but I only paid $750. So even at those prices, it's still double. The market forces really need to ground the 40 series prices before these cards will become relevant. So this is just the 20 series game all over again with Pascal. It's a good card. If you need something new, you need something dense, maybe wait for an open box one or a used one. It's still a good card in a vacuum, but I do caution you to shop around because there are other cards that are older from the 30 series and even some 40 series and a lot of AMD that will meet or beat a lot of these efficiencies for a half or a third the money. So that is my quick run through of the 4070 Ti Super. Again, the dumbest named card in all of human history, but it's pretty good. See you next week.